Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Faiza Sultan and I will be concerned worldwide, which is an international NGO in a sequence as shown on the screen in six parts. First of all, was founded in 1968 by a group of common people in Dublin with focus on poverty relief, and it's presently working in more than 50 countries around the world. Now it's history. Concern Worldwide was founded by a small group of people in Dublin in 1968 following an appeal for aid for war torn Biafra, Africa, and was named as Africa Concern. A ship called Comsail was sent that reached Biafra in September 1968 carrying supplies of powdered food and medicines. In 1970, the people were asked to respond to the cyclone in East Pakistan, which is now Bangladesh, and Africa Concern became Concern Worldwide. It is working in more than 50 countries with 3,200 employees. Concern focus on health, hunger, humanitarian response in emergencies. The charity works in partnership with small community groups as well as government and large global organizations. It is also a certified member of Humanitarian Accountability Partnership. Now a word about its functioning and governance. Concern is controlled and regulated by its members who have responsibility for the articles of association, election of the council, appointment of the auditors and approval of accounts. It consists of 24 members elected at each annual meeting. The council is accountable to ensure that the company's act is adherent to. The donations are put to an appropriate use. It works via self-regulation, compliance verification, and quality assurance certification. Concern Worldwide Constitution was framed and put to implementation in May 20. Now coming over to its hardcore functions that are programs undertaken by Concern Worldwide. The first in the list is livelihood. Approximately 10% of the world's population living below the global poverty line, which is less than $1.90 a day. Extremely poor people in developing countries face many risks associated with climate change, climate-related disasters and negatively impacting on crop yields and the availability of food for farmers. People are increasingly migrating to crowded urban areas in search of more secure livelihoods and are facing increased competition for income-earning opportunities. Thus, Concern enables people living in extreme poverty to forge a way out secure livelihood. Now next is health and nutrition. It is working towards the survival and well-being of the world's most vulnerable communities. Sector-defining programs are changing people's life for the better by working towards the survival and well-being of the world's most vulnerable communities. Thus, Concern Worldwide is ensuring that they obtain the knowledge and resources to keep themselves and their families healthy and nourished. Main areas of focus of Concern Worldwide health and nutrition programs are community management of acute malnutrition, maternal and newborn health, water, sanitization and hygiene, HIV treatment and prevention. Concern Worldwide is also playing its role in education. Education is the key to break poverty cycle in improving health, nutrition, income, and opportunities for all children. There are three key focus areas of work on education are increasing access to education, improving the quality of teachers and learning literacy, in particular literacy through the early grade reading assessment tool. Improving child well-being by providing safe and encouraging learning environments. In emergencies, Concern Worldwide acts quickly to save lives and after the crisis rebuild livelihoods. Concerned worldwide respond rapidly to save lives and reduce suffering. Once the immediate crisis has passed, concerned remain on the ground, helping to people rebuild livelihoods and infrastructure so that communities are better prepared for all future crises. It also advocates for changes in the way the world responds to emergency situations. One of its big programs is gender equality. There are so many women and girls who don't have access to the control over resources and services. They live in fear of gender-biased violations. They are denied to education and have no say over decisions in their homes. Thus, Concerned Worldwide forms a major pillar of Equality Strategy 2016 to 2020 and is a key area of focus for all programs in livelihoods, health, and education. Concerned Worldwide is tackling gender equality to empower people living in extreme poverty by gender sensitive to gender transformation, engaging men, conflict, and gender equality. Concerned Worldwide is also focusing on finding effective solutions to some of the world's biggest problems requiring innovative thinking. Innovation is not simply doing things better. It is creating value at scale with solutions that are more effective, more efficient, and more sustainable. It is about tackling the complex challenges faced by the world's most vulnerable in new ways, but also about applying proven ideas, technologies, and processes from all sectors in adapting established approaches into new contexts, leading to transformation for the poor. Since the NGOs work on fundings to undertake various programs, Concerned Worldwide is organizing different events and creative challenges to keep interest alive, like hikings, trails, and camping. Volunteers are backbone for optimum deliverance and better results. Through volunteer working, they save expenditures and invest more in the programs. Corporate support is also there to fund the Concerned Worldwide to eliminate extreme poverty. Funding is also done by memorial donations, wills, and gifts. With regards to ongoing pandemic COVID-19, Concerned Worldwide is aware that the coronavirus possesses an existential threat to the world's most vulnerable communities. Concerned teams are mobilized to respond to the threat and help save lives. COVID-19 possesses an even larger threat to densely populated countries, which are already struggling with the impact of conflict, climate, and malnutrition. Seriousness of the concern worldwide with regard to COVID-19 is evident from the statement of its CEO, which reads, COVID-19 is a global humanitarian challenge which needs an urgent global response. The world's extreme poor cannot be left to address this crisis on their own. The international community needs to rally behind them to contain the virus. As the faster the virus is stopped, the quicker and stronger the global recovery will be. Thank you very much.